Today we're doing our first AZ500 lab. This is Azure Security. So lab one instructions are at right hand. Let's do it. So search for Azure Active Directory. Okay. And then in the default directory, we are creating users. So let's go to user creation. Where am I? Okay, I'm in the default tenant, right? So go left hand user, my username Joseph. Joseph Price, full name. It's very similar to you create users in the Active Directory on-premise. So nothing new. Just go over password, auto-generated password. Okay, that's fine. Click create. We have to save the username and the password somewhere for the future use. Everything else looked good. Box sign, job info, usage location. Looked fine. Okay, so task number two, use Azure portal to create a senior admin group and add a user account Joseph to the group. Okay, so this is gonna be the user and a group exercise. Group name, security. Oh, sorry. Group type security. Group name senior admins. Okay. Membership types assigned. And the owner and the members. Okay. That's straightforward. No owner for this group, so we add owner there. Add Joseph Price as the owner of the senior admins group. So that's group number one. Okay. Let's go to the group number two. So let's go about PowerShell to create a user. Okay, so this is using PowerShell, not the Azure portal. Oh, great, so let's practice that. New object, Microsoft Open Azure AD module. Password profile, okay. So that's where you store the password profile. Now you create another one to store the password. Okay, and then we have to connect to the AD. So next command is connect Azure AD. That makes sense. Then what we need to do, capture the domain name. So that's the default domain, default tenant. And then we create that user with password profile under the tenant. So let's find out. There we go. Isabel was created. So we now have two users. And now we create a second group. new Azure AD group should come out. Okay. So it's confirmed we have two groups now, junior and senior. Now we have to assign, get a user into the group. So this reference of Isabel as a user, and then we added the user to the junior and the main group, target discipline, okay. Add Azure AD group member. So that was the path, that was the command line. Okay, so we did a command line of creating user and add a user to group. So that's basically a PowerShell. Okay, good. So now we need to create a service desk group. Williams. Okay, Mr. Williams, let's get it done. Use Azure's CLI to create. Okay, so this is the third way of doing it. Change to batch. Domain name. Okay, we got a domain name from command line. That's a reference. And then we do create a user. So AZ add. AZ AD create. AZAD user create. Okay. So the AZ command, which is fine. Easy to remember. So we got done. Still in the CLI, we add a user to the group. Okay, so we're gonna have a some new command to learn. AZ AD group create. AZ AD group list. List all the groups here. With the name as service desk. Perfect. Next. Got a reference for Mr. Williams, and then object ID as a reference of the user. Then we use AZAD group member add command to add object into the service desk group. And list the group member. It's Mr. Williams there. Okay. Also have the user principal name correctly reflected. Great. So exercise 4. Assign the virtual machine contributor role to the service desk group. So two tasks, one create the resource group and assign service desk VM contributor permission. Easy cheesy. Let's go to the resource group. Create a resource group name AZ500-Lab01. That's our first lab. And then location East US. Create. Review and create. There we go. It's going to take it's pretty quick. Right? Now we need to add a role assignment. So we go to the resource group. Go to the access control IAM. role assignment. Virtual machine contributor role. There we go. Assign that to service desk group. So we have to set the scope to user group. Check access. Okay, I have to search the user and okay. So we have check access, role assignment, roles, denying assignment, classic administrator. So check access is that's the way of you can check access of users, right? Yep, it has the virtual machine contributor role there. So we have to repeat the same steps for Joseph Price. I have to go back to IAM and then do everything again. Yeah, found a user, but there's no role assigned, which is expected. All right, that was it. I think. The role-based assignment is pretty straightforward. That concludes the lab. We just need to run the PowerShell to clean up the resources. So open the PowerShell. Oh, I'm still in the bash. Okay, let's switch it again. Paste command line.